Indiana, masterful job by Bobby Knight and company. Rick Pitino's Kentucky Wildcats, the number one seed in the Southeast. And Michigan, playing arguably the toughest schedule in the country. They are number one in the West. Okay, let's take a look in the East first. These are Thursday, Saturday games in Winston-Salem. Number one ranked North Carolina, as we mentioned. They will be taking on the 16th seed there, East Carolina. The Pirates, first team since Montana State in 86 to come into the tournament with a losing record. The 8th seed, Rhode Island. Congratulations to Al's first appearance since 88. They will take on Purdue and their sensational sophomore, Glenn Robinson. Brian Mahoney, sensational job at St. John's, 5th seed. He's the Big East Coach of the Year. St. John's will meet Texas Tech. James Dickey, the head coach there, second-year coach, magnificent job. Arkansas will hold down the 4th seed in the East, and the Razorbacks of Nolan Richardson will take on Holy Cross. George Blaney in his 21st season at his alma mater. Now, these games are Friday-Sunday games in Syracuse in the East. The number 6 seed, Virginia. Jeff Jones, well, I tell you, they started off 11-0, finished 8-9, but they're in the big dance. They will be taking on Manhattan, the Jaspers' first appearance since 1958, the same year the head coach Fran Fraschello was born. Happy birthday. Number 3 seed goes to Massachusetts. John Calipari went back to his old coaching style. They're in the NCAAs, taking on the team from the Ivy League's 14th-seeded Pennsylvania, undefeated in Ivy League play. The number 7 seed, New Mexico State. Swift, Sam Crawford, the man there, as they will play Nebraska, the number 10 seed. All right, the number 2 seed, Cincinnati, synonymous with defense there. Number 15, Coppin State. Fang Mitchell, the head coach there, they were undefeated in MEAC play. Now to the Midwest. These are Thursday, Saturday games in Chicago. The number 6 seed, the California Golden Bears, under interim coach Todd Bozeman, went 9-1 since the firing of Lou Capinelli. They will play the LSU Fighting Tigers. Dale Brown's team did it on the strength of postseason play. The Duke Blue Devils hold down a number 3 seed in the Midwest. Mike Krzyzewski's team will take on the 14th seed, Southern Illinois, first appearance since 1970. The BYU Cougars hold down the number 7 seed. They will play 10th seed at SMU. John Shoemate, remarkable turnaround job for the Mustangs. Number 2 seed, the Kansas Jayhawks, stumbled a bit in postseason play, but Roy Williams' team is in, and the Kansas Jayhawks will play Ball State, the Cardinals' third appearance in the last 5 years. And Friday, Sunday location in Indianapolis, of course, the number 1 ranked Indiana Hoosiers, Bob Knight's team, maybe without Alan Henderson, will take on the 16th seed, Wright State, just their 6th season in Division I play. They won the Division II championship back in 83. Number 8 seed, New Orleans, the Privateers, have a senior by the name of Irvin Johnson. Don't call him magic, but he can play. The number 9 seed, Xavier of Ohio, out of the MCC, 7th appearance in the last 8 years for Pete Gillen. The number 5 seed is Oklahoma State, coached by the master, Eddie Sutton. They are in the tournament. Will take on Marquette, Kevin O'Neill. Super job there, first appearance since 1983. Denny Crum, the old hand, back in the tournament again. 17 appearances and 2 national championships. And the Cardinals will take on Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Second consecutive appearance for the Delaware Blue Hens. Games in Orlando. The 6th seed, Kansas State, had a strong postseason appearance here. 5th time in the tournament in the last 7 years. They will take on Perry Clark's Tulane Green Wave. Stumbled down the stretch, but they're in nonetheless. The number 3 seed, Florida State Seminoles, led by the trio of Sam Cassell, Charlie Ward, and Bob Sir, will host the 14th seed, Evansville Aces, Jim Cruz, a Bob Knight disciple there. The 7th seed, Western Kentucky, Ralph Willard has the Hilltoppers in. They were the Sun Belt Conference tournament champions, and they will play the 10th seeded Memphis State Tigers, led by Do Everything player Anthony Penny Hardaway. The number 2 seed, Seton Hall, on a roll coming into the tournament, won their last 11 games, including the Big East Championship today. They will play the 15th seed Tennessee State Tigers. Hats off to Frankie Allen, his second year there, took a team that was 4-24 last year. They're 19-9. All right, these games are Friday, Sunday in Nashville, the other half of the Southeast. Number 1 ranked Kentucky, the number 1 seed there, that is. They will take the 16th seed Ryder Bronx, making their first appearance since 1984. Utah holds down the 8th seed, Rick Majerus, the big man, doing a big job there. The 9th seed, Pittsburgh Pirates are in the tournament's strong schedule from the Big East. The fifth seed, Wake Forest, the Demon Deacons, led by All-American forward Rodney Rogers, will play the 12th seed of Tennessee, Chattanooga Moccasins. Mac McCarthy, the coach there, first appearance since 1988. The fourth seed, the Iowa Hawkeyes, who have overcome all kinds of adversity this year. Tom Davis has his team in there for the eighth time in the last 9 years, will take on Northeast Louisiana. All right, now let's move on to Salt Lake City. These are Thursday, Saturday games in the West region. Finally, the sixth seed, the Fighting Illini of Illinois, Lou Henson, 10th appearance for a lose do there. The 11th seed, Long Beach State, strong postseason play, quality wins over then number one ranked Kansas back in Lawrence, Kansas, showed everyone they are for real. The third seed, the Vanderbilt Commodores. Eddie Fogler has Billy McCaffrey playing for him, and they're doing an outstanding job. The 14th seed, they will play Boise State, the Broncos, out of the Big Sky. The seventh seed, Temple Owls. Now, a lot of argument as to whether or not Temple or Michigan had the tougher schedule. You take your pick. John Chaney's team is in. They will play the 10th seeded Missouri Tigers. What a weekend here in Kansas City for Norm Stewart. They knocked off Oklahoma State, Iowa State, and Kansas State to win the Big 8 tournament. All right, the number two seed, Arizona, is there in Salt Lake City. Ninth consecutive year that Arizona has received the bid. They will play the 15th seed, Santa Clara Broncos. All right, Friday, Sunday games in Tucson. Number one ranked Michigan, the number one seed there, that is. They will be playing the 16th seed, Coastal Carolina, led by Tony Slam Duncan, a four-time Big South Player of the Year. The eighth seed, Iowa State, the senior statesman, Johnny Orr, showing he can still coach, taking on the ninth seed, UCLA Bruins. Jim Harrick just received a three-year contract on Tuesday. Congratulations, you're in the tournament. New Mexico State has the fifth seed. Dave Bliss's squad will take on a team that is certainly cheering down in the foggy bottom in Washington, D.C. George Washington in for the first time in 32 years. The fourth seed goes to Georgia Tech. I tell you, they won the ACC postseason tournament over North Carolina, and Georgia Tech will play the winner of the Southwestern Athletic Conference Championship, right now being played between Jackson State and Southern. All right, now you may be asking, what about teams that had their bubbles burst?